Now, the research side, the first thing we did is we started with the Cleveland Clinic, and it was interesting to see the presentation this morning. I met with Dr. Roizen, who is the first chief wellness officer for a corporation in America, and he is the chief wellness officer in the Cleveland Clinic. My first meeting with him was so intense and so disturbing to me, I had to come back. And when I share with you the numbers, you will know why. And so the first question we had is that wellness is here to solve a problem. So let's figure out, what's the problem? Now, Dr. Roizen shared that in 1984 was the tipping point for our nation. That's when, after 100 years, that the average person per capita, we started taking on 400 more calories a day. It's about a pound and a half a year. But to compound that, in the 1990s, we became an exceedingly sedentary culture. Schools, workplace. Now, that's created a burning platform issue, and it's called chronic disease. 50% of the population has some form of chronic disease. And it's rising at a 7% compounded rate. So all the work we're trying to do to fix healthcare, that isn't root cause. What's driving it is chronic disease. 70% of our population is either overweight or obese. Now, I've been doing work in education, and 20% of freshmen entering college are either overweight or obese. But when they leave, 40% are. We've set them up for life failure in just 4 years. So here's the implication. Right now, we spend 18% of our GDP on health costs. How many of you are math experts in this room? Great at math, okay? You're wellness experts, I understand that. So you're not math experts, but I'll help you out. 7% compounded means that within the next 10 to 15 years, that 18% GDP will go to 36% GDP. The $12,500 that companies spend on average per employee for benefits will go to $25,000. Your taxes will double. So if you want to talk about economic impact and social disruption, that's the picture Dr. Roizen painted for me. And I left for the very first time in my life feeling like we have an existential crisis as a nation. Now, then we flipped over to say, so let's look at the solution, wellness. Soren Matke, who's the author of the RAND Report, and I read the RAND Report and I interviewed him, said, if the definition of wellness programs is that it improves the health and happiness of employees and lowers costs, they don't work. It's a definitive study, and we've got lots of studies that show that. And then when we went to the leading wellness expert at Johns Hopkins, they've got a great report on the 10 things you need to do to have an effective wellness program. And we buy into that because we did talk to companies that have very effective wellness programs. But when you look at it, I was at breakfast this morning with a person who said, boy, we're almost ready to go. It's just the CEO doesn't believe in wellness. Well, that's one of the pieces. And in this program, you have to have all 10 pieces. Robust change management. You have to change the environment. All these things. So I asked the author of the report, I said, wow, who's capable of doing this? His direct, exact words. Very, 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 very few companies are capable of doing this.